As life begins to return to normal for many Aussies, New South Wales is finally tasting that long-awaited freedom. Eased restrictions now paving the way for a COVID-normal Christmas, but authorities warn we are definitely not out of the woods just yet. Pleased to say New South Wales Premier Gladys Berejiklian joins us live now from Sydney for more. Premier, we'll get to those restrictions in just a moment. First, I want to talk to you about the rollout of a coronavirus vaccine in the UK. We've seen the first jabs overnight. What sort of hope does that give you in terms of Australia's vaccination plan?
Oh, look, it's a very hopeful and optimistic sign, and we welcome that. And certainly the advice I've had from experts is that they do expect a vaccine that will be available to the community at some stage next year. But Tom, what concerns me, and as the Premier of the largest state in Australia, I have to assume there won't be a vaccine. We have to make sure we get used to living in a COVID-safe way. Even when the vaccine is first available, it won't be available to everybody. So this does still mean that we'll need to live in a COVID-safe while for a while. But what it does mean is that we can look forward to 2021 being with a bit more hope and a bit more optimism. But in the meantime, it's really, really important for us to maintain our social distancing where possible, to make sure that we're keeping our hands clean, make sure that we get tested even if we have the mildest symptom. It's really important to follow those rules because we know the risks are there. When you have thousands of people coming back home through the airports every week, you know that there's a risk. When people have the virus on Australian soil, there's always a risk. And that's why it's really important for us to be COVID safe. And as we go into summer, when we're with family and loved ones and the number of gatherings or the number of people in a gathering are going up, that always increases the risk. And that's why we have to be extra careful.
Just quickly before we move on, will you be getting the jab?
Look, I will wait my turn. The federal government has been talking to the states about who would get priority and who wouldn't. And I think we just have to wait and see. I certainly would make sure that those who need it first get it first. But all of the rest of us have to make sure that we're living in a very COVID-safe way. And the last thing any of us want to see is our friends or loved one get the virus because we haven't been careful in our homes or when we're going out socialising. There's no doubt our summer will be freer than what we've experienced in the last few months. But we just need to make sure that we do it in a safe way. Even when we're going to the beach or a park, we need to be careful to make sure if someone does have the virus, they may not know they've got it. Chances are they won't know they've got it. We need to make sure it doesn't spread to others in the community.
Yeah, how much of a worry is that for you that, people do see the restrictions easing and then this mentality, I guess, of complacency starts to set in that perhaps people think, that's it, we're over it?
Well, I think complacency is something all of us have to grapple with because especially when you have continuous days of no community transmission, people start to ease back and think, oh, well, life can get back to normal. Unfortunately, it can't. Until every single person in the community is immunised against the virus, until everybody has the vaccine, we have to live in a COVID-safe way. And I think in New South Wales, people understand that. And I'm so pleased that whether it's businesses enforcing the QR codes we have, whether it's individuals and families being careful, especially around those more vulnerable members of the family, and whether it's individuals just making sure they're taking precautions. I think in New South Wales, given what we've been through, people have demonstrated resilience, but they've also demonstrated outstanding care for one another and really been on high alert when it comes to the virus. And I just ask everybody, please don't let your guard down, including myself. It's really easy when you see people you haven't seen for a long time, when you're with people who you love deeply over this period, please make sure that you stay safe. We don't want anybody unintentionally getting ill and the virus getting out of control, because that would mean New South Wales has to go backwards. And we've done really well so far, and I don't think any of us want to see us going backwards.
Look, the ban on cruising in Australia, it's been now extended until at least March. If there is no active COVID in the community at the moment, why not at least try and start the domestic cruising industry? A lot of jobs depend on this industry, and it could give it a vital boost.
Look, I don't blame authorities for taking a cautious approach to that. We know big ships have crews on them from all around the world. They dock in very different places. They may be in contact with people who've been on flights, on international flights or local flights. So there are concerns around that, and I appreciate why people are taking a cautious approach. I do think it's better to be safe than sorry. There's no doubt all of us are dreaming about our first holiday and what that might look like. For many of us, travelling around our own state has been a joy during a time when ordinarily we may have been elsewhere, and I think that's been a good time for all of us as well. But I think all of us are thinking about where the next holiday might be, and hopefully people around the world, once the vaccine's available, are thinking about coming to Australia, because we desperately want that tourism industry to revive. But I think it's important to have a cautious approach, and I think it's important for us to keep everybody safe and the economy open as much as possible before we introduce that type of risk.
All right, Premier, we appreciate your time.